Well, we're back with one of my favorite sites. Well, soon to be a favorite site,
soon
actually.
To be a favorite
yes,
site.
Because I already had a favorite site, and that was called Wordle.
I love Wordle. It's a really great site.
Yep,
really
and
is.
In the classroom, we always did a Wordle of the day where I would put together a whole bunch of words, and the task was for the students to figure out what those words had in common.
Right.
And every day they'd come in, and a new Wordle was projected on the screen, and they had to find the commonality, and they got harder and harder. And I had to give a shout out to Jen Wagner, who supplied me with those Wordles of the day.
Right.
Awesome. And she does a website with it, and you can go
cool.
on, and it's like a puzzle.
So what? So Wordle is, what is a Wordle?
So,
I want to explain what that is, why you love it, and all that kind
well,
of stuff.
Well, you can do so much with Wordle, and it's free. Wordle.net is free. And what you do is you go on to Wordle.net, and there's a gallery of Wordles that people already created. Mm-hmm. So it's nice because you can get an idea of some of the things you might want to do with that. But you can just go to create, and all you have to do is you can either type in some text or you can just paste in a bunch of text.
Mm-hmm.
And what I'm going to do here is I emailed myself the text from Obama's recent speech.
Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and just copy all of this text right here. And this is really nice to do with, for example, if students are writing an essay and you want to show them how they've overused particular words, you might want to use something like a word cloud, because a word cloud allows the most commonly used words to show up because they get larger.
So the more times a word appears in that block of text, the bigger it will become.
Correct.
The more prominent.
So
again, great, and it's also a great way to visualize what the students have written as well.
So really, here, this mm-hmm. speech is now in Wordle, and what you'll see is now that it's working. Hopefully, yeah, there we go. It's going to take all these words and put them into a free form, kind of like a little artistic visualization.
Right.
And with Wordle, you can sort of play with the layout and the colors and all that, and you can see that some of the words have been used more than the others, like people and hearts and tragedy
right.
Gabby and Christine and just.
Yeah,
okay.
Right.
So it really brings to the forefront the words that are most dominant in the speech.
Okay.
You can also type in the words, and you can, and like I said, I use this in class because you can push the words. So if you want to type in a bunch of words and you want particular words to come be the largest, you can just type those in a couple more times. And
mm-hmm.
so the students, you know, so if you put this up on the screen, the students may, not knowing what the context is,
mm-hmm.
if they really study this for a few moments, they might actually be able to guess this
exactly.
is from the speech.
And Sunshine really State Standards, main idea. I mean, this
deep
is a great
thinking.
Way to visualize
yeah.
those kind of
Absolutely.
Things.
Absolutely.
So
I always love Wordle, and thanks to Jen Wagner for introducing me to Wordle, because I didn't know anything about it. And Wordle of the Day is just a great way to spend 3, 4, 5 minutes every single day
cool.
really making the kids think deeply. Now, if you like Wordle, you will love Wordsift.
That was an awesome intro. You kind of lost me there because it was like, really?
Yes.
It's really that good?
Yes, it's
it is
really that
really
good.
That good? Okay. I can hardly wait to see it.
I'm sensing a bit of sarcasm. Well, Wordsift takes Wordle and puts it on steroids.
Cool.
Okay, so I'm going to paste in the same text.
All right.
And I'm going to click sift. And as it sifts, it's going to create the same type of word cloud.
Okay.
It's going to use just some of the words. And see, it didn't create an artistic version of it. Okay, all it did was bring the most used words to the forefront. So it didn't include all the little words.
Okay.
All right. And you can then sort common to rare to common, A to Z, and so on. Okay, and you can squish the cloud and unsquish the cloud.
Okay.
And you can mark the, say, the science words.
Oh, wow.
Okay, and it's going to refresh in a second.
That's interesting.
Or not. Okay, there we go.
Oh, wow.
So it pulled a couple of these and said they're science words, social studies words, math words, and so on. Okay. I'm going to unmark those. And one of the nice things you can also do here is you can choose one of the words. I'm going to choose American. And it will also search for images over here, okay,
that is way cool.
Have to do with the word that you picked, all right? And it will also, or it should, let's see, let's find, here's friend.
Right.
And now it's pulled
also got
up words.
That little visual mm-hmm. representation of the word and other words that are associated.
Right, with definitions.
Wow.
So, and then of course it uses Visual Thesaurus. Okay, this is a free version of Visual Thesaurus. Mm-hmm. And then I think it prompts you then to go sign up for a full version of it.
Right.
But it then gives you like a word web that branches out
right.
into others. So here we have friend, and then you've got ally and acquaintance and foe, which so it brings you to antonyms as well.
Antonyms, right. Cool.
Right. So you can start clicking around here, and you can drag these around.
And when you actually click on it, it's going to expand it out and really kind of refocus it on the word that you've clicked on.
Yep, exactly. Now, one of the nice things you can also do is you can create a workspace. So I create a workspace here, and I can take the word family, okay, and paste it here, and friend, and future, okay, and then I can choose a word, say the word time, and I can make the images draggable.
Wow.
And now what I'm going to do is say take this image and put it right here, and maybe this image here, okay, and maybe I want to use here, I want to take year and make the image draggable. Oh my, okay, maybe world and make these images draggable. We'll take there, that one.
Okay.
Okay. And one of the other things you can do is when you choose a word, down here you can see where the word is
right.
in context. And I chose the word
world.
Okay.
So it's actually why you chose the word, and then it shows the text.
The
that
context.
You pasted in
correct.
And where it appears there. So you can read the entire sentence and see it in context.
Correct. And when
got
you
it.
Click on it, it will then take you to that
wow.
part of the text.
And highlight the sentence.
And highlight
where it,
it.
Wow.
Right. Isn't
that's
that
like
nice?
A whole toolbox of,
right.
of language acquisition and understanding vocabulary. That's really a nice site. I
isn't
like that
nice?
A lot.
So you have all these things you can do with it. Now, it doesn't allow you to take your workspace and like export it.
Right.
But what you can do is you can capture a screenshot.
Mm-hmm.
And that's always nice, you know, you can take a screenshot and there's a lot you can do with that. You can make a card or you can make a timeline or you can use arrows and, mm-hmm. and create your own sort of visual thesaurus type of web.
I see.
You know,
I see.
Type of...
And then how about the styling on the word cloud? Does it have styling options like Wordle does where you can change the colors and all that kind of thing? Or is that one thing that's not in this version yet?
I did not see that.
Okay.
Now, I did take the video tour, and it's really, it's about 3 or 4 minutes long, and
right.
you watch, I guess, the person who put this together.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually put out by Stanford University,
okay.
and you see the person taking you through all the features. And I think the intent here is not to be so much artsy,
uh-huh.
but it's really more of like an ELL
okay.
resource.
So for again,
people
language
who are
acquisition,
speaking.
they're not native speakers and they want to understand words and their association
exactly.
with each other, it's great.
Yeah, so you know, you click the word man, okay, and it takes you to all kinds of resources for the word man. You've got images, you've got synonyms, you've got antonyms, you can drag it around, you
right.
can create your own little, say, index card or flash
that's
card.
Great. That's
yeah,
great.
So it's really nice.
That's awesome, Lee.
So you've got Wordle, and then you've got Wordsift.
Wordsift.
Wordle
got a
on steroids.
Whole great
yeah.
new set
nice
of tools. Thanks, Lee. Appreciate that.
Yeah, we'll be back with more Palm Breeze Cafe, so don't go away.